Joining us now for more on the survey is Leo La Rosa. He's the Director for Communications and Information Technology and the spokesperson of Social Weather Stations. Good morning, sir. Thank you for taking our call.
Good morning, Vivian, and good morning to all your viewers.
Yes, sir. The surveys show that the number of Filipino families who went hungry doubled from last December to this May. What was the reason behind it, according to the respondents that you surveyed, and how can this be addressed?
Well, unfortunately, since it's a phone interview, we can only conduct the interview to up to 20 minutes maximum. Because of that, we can only limit our questions to very focused questions. So this question on hunger is the standard hunger questions that we run in our regular quarterly face-to-face surveys. But since we were unable to run our usual face-to-face surveys because of the lockdown, this phone interview, this new survey, had to be implemented as a response to the lockdown. So when we asked this question, as reported by Bruce earlier, it only asked about their experience and about the intensity of the hunger they experienced. But unfortunately, we are unable to put in more questions to ask the reason for them feeling this hunger. But of course, if we just compare it with the last quarter of 2019, it really doubled in terms of percentage and in terms of estimate, which only shows that if we ask the question of experiencing hunger in the past 3 months, this pandemic really has an effect on their people, on the family's experience of hunger. And we have to emphasize that this is the kind of hunger that we call involuntary, meaning this is not because of dieting or because they are they just don't want to eat, but involuntary hunger, meaning they have they experience hunger because there is nothing to eat or they have no means of getting food.
All right. You did mention that the survey was conducted via mobile phone and computer assisted interviews. I wish to know, what are the challenges of holding the survey using this methodology compared to the usual face-to-face interviews?
Well, as mentioned earlier, we only have up to 20 minutes a window time to conduct the survey because there's the thing we call respondent fatigue. In this case, since it's a phone call, the mode of interviewing is via phone, this respondent fatigue sets in much earlier compared to a face-to-face interview. So because of that, we have to shorten our questionnaire drastically from our regular, probably more than 150 questions if we implemented by face-to-face. We are just down to less than 40. So that's the biggest challenge. And of course, another challenge would be the network infrastructure. Sometimes reaching the sample numbers, the randomly selected numbers from our database, sometimes we get unproductive calls. But of course, we do our best to reach the respondent as we do unlimited attempts to reach the respondent. And probably I should mention that one of the challenges would be also technological, because even with 20 minutes worth of interview, sometimes when you do it by phone, you get disconnected. Sometimes their phones will go low on power. So there are many factors that we have experienced when conducting the survey. But we were, if I may say, very successful in terms of coming up with a very sufficient sample to represent a nationwide survey.
Right. The survey sample, do you think it is representative of the population, considering that there are still a number of Filipinos who have no access to internet?
Well, yes, because this sampling that we used for the mobile survey is a probability-based sampling also, because it is the numbers were randomly selected from the SWS database that has begun its compilation since December of 2017. We were able to build this database by asking our respondents from our standard face-to-face interviews if they give us permission to conduct interviews to them in the future using mobile phone surveys. So if they give their consent, we get their numbers, and that's added to the SWS database. So this database is a probability base. It's taken from samples of representative surveys that we do quarterly since as early as 1992. So we are very confident with the representativeness of this sample, even if true that it's only 49% nationwide Filipinos has access to the internet. Mm-hmm. But mobile phones, on the other hand, is a device that's widely owned by our countrymen.
Mm-hmm. And the SWS survey or surveyed 4,010 respondents, is that right? And this sample, I believe, is appears bigger than the usual sample for national surveys. How did we arrive at that sample size, and what is its effect on the margin of error?
Well, we originally targeted more, because for us to be able to analyze the data at the regional level, we have to be targeting at least 200 or more per region. So 4,010 is actually very decent. We were targeting for more. So it's actually targeted to up to 8,000. But the completed interviews at the end of the 7-day period turns out to be 4,010. And if you look at the regional distribution of the sample, this is posted in the SWS website, we're pretty confident that we have had enough sample to represent each region. So with the 4,010, that brings the error margin for the nationwide reading to a very accurate plus or minus 2%. Mm-hmm. So this is much higher compared to the usual 1,200 that we use for our standard face-to-face surveys. And also, because we have bigger sample for the mobile phone survey, we can do closer analysis of the upper region. So this data is capable of being analyzed at the regional level, because we've had enough sample representing each region.
Mm-hmm. And these mobile phone and computer assisted surveys, will this be the new normal for SWS and conducting surveys amid this COVID-19 pandemic?
Well, we will still be going back as soon as the lockdown is lifted. We will be going back to our standard face-to-face interviews, because, it's still the best mode of interviewing if you are going to tackle with a lot of issues, a lot of topics. But of course, we are also preparing for this new normal, for the new normal that people have to stay at home. We have to protect them as well as our field staff. So probably, yes, we are also getting ready for this kind of new normal.
Mm. And how do we intend to cover the poorer parts or members of society who probably have no access even to mobile phones?
We will have to depend on our database still, because that database had enough representation from all the sample, the respondents we have in the past. So this database, we are confident, has enough representation from the lower class respondents, in middle class and upper classes, because we've had enough respondents beginning December of 2017, was given their permission to be interviewed. So these numbers are not randomly generated numbers. These mm-hmm. numbers are based on a nationally representative sample that was compiled through the years since December 2017. So we are pretty confident that we will be covering, we will have enough sample to be to draw from for our power poorer respondents.
And finally, sir, what are the other surveys that will be conducted via these mobile and computer-assisted interviews?
Well, if we have enough funding to conduct something like this again, we hope to do it more regularly. But to be frank about it, this particular survey was conducted through our own initiative. So we dug into our savings to be able to do this. Also part of our mission to continue social research, even with the lockdown, even with this pandemic.
Thank you for your time, SWS spokesperson and Director for Communications and Information Technology, Leo La Rosa.
Thank you very much.